You know what I'm going to say? Recently, I saw a posting online, and someone said...
Was it a quote?
No. Oh. I don't do any of that highbrow stuff.
Was it a...
No, it was a posting somebody put on saying they were big Transformer fans.
Yep.
And that they were fans of the original Transformers, the movie that came out. And and today, or that day when I saw the post, it was the 30th anniversary of that movie being released in theaters in 1986.
Yep.
Okay. So I guess the guy, whoever the guy was a huge fan of it. And I guess there were certain theaters, I don't know where, that were showing the movie again, the full-length animated movie from 86.
Around here?
No, I don't know where this was. This was somewhere. It definitely wasn't around here.
Yeah.
But so they, you know, showed the movie and stuff. And when I saw that, man, see, it took me back.
Took you back to what?
It took me back, man. See, back to my childhood, man.
I don't want to go back to my childhood.
Well, your childhood was mixed with a lot of religious beatings, getting kicked out of subways, and pissing all night.
No, not pissing all night.
Okay, I'm sorry. Holding your piss all night.
Holding my piss all night. And then quickly relieving myself of my pants on the way to the bathroom.
There you go. And then promptly getting another beating. But my childhood was a little bit more special than that. Just a little bit.
Special education?
Well, close. Listen, my childhood was full of air conditioning, fighting robots, and then later on at night fighting parents. But I digress.
I don't know how I survived in New York with no air conditioning. I don't know. We had heat.
Yeah.
No AC. How?
I have no idea. But I know the theater that I saw the movie had AC. Looking back at this movie, man, you remember the Transformers movie, right?
Yeah, it was a freaking musical.
No, it wasn't a musical. There was music in it.
Yeah, it played music.
Yeah, dude, listen. I was a huge fan. Still am a fan of it.
Yeah,
but I was
me too.
A huge fan of the Transformers when they first came out. What do you mean, transforming robots from Japan that transform into all kinds of vehicles, fight each other for 30 minutes? What? You mean there's a toy line?
to sell toys?
Sign me up. I'm in.
And they fought G.I. Joe.
Not in the cartoon.
No, in the comic.
In the comic. Hasbro owned all of it. So Hasbro was like, yo.
Crossover.
Money! That's all they said. Yo,
they're like, a crossover.
Yo, all the... From yen to dollar.
Yeah.
No, like kids and, you know, the fans of it were like, oh, man, that'd be great. Like you said, crossover. Oh, the story possibilities. The story arcs. This is going to be great. Hasbro, the owner of the company, all they thought was this. That's it. That is it. And it worked out for everybody.
Yeah, it did.
Because people got plenty of great stories, and then, you know, Hasbro made all the money.
I mean, they're still making money off of it.
Yeah, they're still making money.
Three Netflix shows.
Yeah, I haven't seen those yet. I don't know how good. The animation looks real spotty.
I mean, it's computer.
I know, but it looks spotty. The series came out, I was hooked. So I was watching it all the time. It was great. I mean, you know, I kind of look back at the cartoon now, and it's just kind of like,
cheesy.
Boy, yeah. These scripts really weren't as good as I remember them. And they weren't. Some of them were just downright awful.
All of them were downright awful. The whole series was awful.
Yes, yeah. No, well, you know.
It's animation got the nostalgia. Was shitty.
No, the animation was good the first couple seasons. It was.
No, it wasn't.
Yeah, it was.
No,
yeah, it was. It was. The animation
was terrible.
The first three episodes were fantastic. The animation was great. It wasn't until like the third season where the animation took a huge. It was after the movie. After the movie, the animation took a huge dive.
It was all terrible.
No, it wasn't. It wasn't. It was all right. I mean, like I said, look, it's being marketed to kids so they could sell toys.
Yeah.
So as a kid, you're thinking, man, this is like Shakespeare level stuff. As an adult, you're like, well, was I stupid or what? Listening to this shit.
Yeah.
But regardless, huge fan of it.
The fucking villain always got away, even though, you know.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Next time,
like,
no, don't follow. We'll get him next time.
We'll get him next time. No!
Really?
Kill him!
Kill him
so
now!
So you don't have to get him next time.
It's called a war.
Yeah, it's, yeah, it was a little. But anyway, the cartoon was so great that when they said, yo, we're coming out with a movie, the first thing I thought of was, I knew they would, because at that time, they were turning any property they could into a movie.
Yeah.
You know, the G.I. Joe, the, you know.
Oh, that was a travesty.
Yeah, well. So, the movie comes out. Man, I tell my mom, yo, I got to go see it. Takes the whole family, takes me, takes my sister, takes my brother. We all go to see Transformers, right? I already knew that this thing probably wasn't going to make a whole lot of money because, you know, back then they used to have like multiple showings, 5, 6, 7 showings a day of a movie. Yo, this had like 2 showings.
Yep.
2 o'clock and 4 o'clock. That's it.
Because it was a cartoon.
Yeah. And on the marquee, they had like, each movie had its own marquee and its own theater. So in theater one, Aliens is playing. In theater two, Ferris Bueller's playing. Nothing else is playing there all day. Transformers, they had another movie playing there for part of the day and then in the small part underneath, the Transformers. So they had the Transformers playing in that theater for like basically 5 hours, for 4 hours. And then the other, and I thought that was weird. I'd never seen that before. And I was like, that's not a good sign. So go in, get the popcorn, I sit down, and I'm ready to watch fucking Japanese robot action.
The Japanese like Japanese robot action, except that it's naked robots.
Yeah, it usually involves naked robots and
with used panties.
Yeah, and girls in sailor suits getting like fucking fingered. Uh-huh. With octopuses. It's always an octopus. Very weird shit. So I'm in there. I'm thinking, oh, my God, it's going to be great. And the minute the DEG logo comes in with the lion, and I'm like, oh, this is it. This is it. And sure enough, man, I will say animation-wise, I was blown away.
Yeah.
Beautiful animation. To this day, the animation still holds up in terms of the color, in terms of the movie. It was just, you know, it was like, it was so different from the cartoon.
Of course, because, you know.
It was a movie, yeah. It was a higher budget.
People actually kind of died.
Yeah. Well, no. That was definitely different. And you start to see familiar characters from the TV series that you remember. Optimus Prime, like Jazz, Ironhide, all these, you know, the old Prowl, all these old school characters. Then all of a sudden, there's an ominous kind of tone coming with one particular scene when they're in that shuttle. And there's 4 of the original, like, good guys, the Autobots.
Oh, yeah.
And the Decepticons come break in.
Oh, yeah, they got shot. Yeah,
and they got killed. And they cue up the Instruments of Destruction song.
Yeah.
And it's this hard rock song, and then Brawn gets up, and he's like, oh, Decepticons. And you're thinking, okay, it's going to be like the TV series. And Megatron transforms into a gun.
And just starts,
and says, die, Autobots, and let the blood flow. Or the oil, I should say. Yo, they were getting clipped as a kid. I'm like, what the fuck? Why are they not getting up like in the cartoon? And that was it.
Yeah.
That was it. I was stunned. I was like, what the fuck is happening?
I mean, it lasted throughout the whole series. Now they died.
Now everybody's dying.
Yeah.
Crazy. And then obviously, like, you know, Optimus Prime, the part where he comes in and he, like, beats him and fights Megatron to the death. But then it was like, whoa. He beat Megatron, but he also fell, which was unusual for the cartoon. I'm like, what's going on? What the hell? You know, like, you know, my man was sideswiped. I'm like, yo, please don't kill this motherfucker.
Oh.
So then here I am at 10 years old watching all these great characters from the TV series die. And then now the main guy is going to die?
Yeah.
So then they put, I remember Optimus Prime when he died, they had him on the thing.
Yeah.
And he's going out. They put the slow music on. Listen, Mr. I'm not lying.
You cried.
No, I didn't cry, but I was standing there shocked with my mouth open. I look over to the side, and I could see this kid that's in the next row to the left. Yo, kid had tears running down his eyes.
Oh, God.
I was like, what the fuck are they doing, man? What the fuck are they doing? So the kid is, like, tearing up. Like, you see the tears running down his face and shit, and it was like, yeah, he's dead. And I'm thinking, all right, he'll come back.
Nope.
And nope, done.
He did in the series.
Oh, I mean, yeah, because
as a Transformers ghost.
Yeah, no, because they got fucking inundated with letters from angry parents like, yo, my kid locked himself in the fucking in his room and he won't come out. It's been 3 weeks. You need to fix this. Yeah, they treated that shit like it was an actual funeral, like somebody really died. Yeah, and they brought him back. They were like, yo, listen, like, you know.
As a force ghost.
Yeah, no. What it was that, as you know, because he died, you know, the parents were like, yo, you need to fix this. I've had a talk with my kid, you know, about death. You guys need to make this right, okay? Now, the people at Hasbro, they thought to themselves, they're like, bring him right back. And that's what they did. And they brought him back because Hasbro was like, we can use this emotional damage that we've caused many kids to our financial advantage.
Let's say what kind of kids it is. White kids.
No, hell no. There were plenty of black and Hispanic kids.
Come on, you think so? No.
Yo, in my school, yo, we were all like, I mean, we weren't crying about it. We were like, yo, can you believe what the fuck happened?
Yeah, but there was no emotional damage. It was like, oh, man, can you believe that?
Well, I got to admit, I couldn't walk by a red truck without feeling a little remorseful.
I wasn't crying.
Oh, you had no emotion.
You know, I was like, oh, man, it's a cartoon.
Yo, dude. Yo, and then the whole thing fucking finally ends, and it's just kind of like, what the fuck happened to all these great characters, and how in the hell is this series going to move forward? And to you, or to me anyway, that felt like the most important thing that happened to me all fucking summer, which shows what kind of life I had.
It did move forward.
Yeah.
And it came out with a brand new cartoon.
Which they did, yep.
And a brand new cartoon made money.
Which is, in the end, the most important thing.
They moved on.
Yes, they did. Good part about that is they left us with a kick-ass soundtrack.
Oh, God.
You know you get a little misty-eyed when you hear The Touch come on.
No. I don't.
All right, I got to admit, some of those songs didn't age too well.
They didn't age well at all.
Well, no, a few of them. But
you got The Touch. You got the power. All right.
Yeah, that's one that aged a little.
After all, the said and done. You never walk. You never run. You're a winner. Like a self-affirmation. Got the rules.
It was
you
the know 80s,
the
man.
Streets. Take the route. Take the heat. You're nobody's fool.
Hold on. Do you remember this from the movie or do you remember this from Boogie Nights?
The movie.
Okay.
Something to something is done.
No, he didn't say something to something.
You were stretched again. You'll never give up.
No, he didn't say that.
I don't know. I'm just making it up from memory.
I know you're making it up.
You got the chance.
Although I got to admit, sounds pretty close. Hey, listen. Don't denigrate my childhood, man.
Because
honestly, kind of all I got right now.
I mean, that's all you're going to ever have.
Well, no. I have this podcast.
Oh, God. You have nothing.
Pretty much.